Who make it back are forever changed.
Magic, dark magic, a trick.
Raven,
tricking her.
Raven,
how can she get up?
Wait,
it's him.
Dark magic draws her closer.
It's not him. He's helping her. It's not him.
It's a trick.
She's doing it on her own. He's not tricking her. It's magic.
It's an illusion.
He's down! Finish him! Finish him! Finish him! Ymir was a frost giant, a being of darkness. And all his sons and grandsons were dark after him. Of his daughters and granddaughters, some were monstrous, but others fair. But there was another who came from the ice, Buri. In shape, he was like a man, big and powerful. His son, Bor, took a fair giant to be his wife, and they had three sons. Odin was the eldest, and the Northmen hold him to be the foremost of the gods, the old father.
Do you know what it's like to leave everything behind? Your home, loved ones, to head deep into the wilds, perhaps never to return. Senua does. Because when darkness speaks, it changes everything. Turning home into a foreign land and loved ones into strangers. Exile makes sense when you realize that you were never really home in the first place.
A long time.
Why did she go to the wilds?
She wanted to fight her own darkness. She thought she could beat her own darkness.
Did she beat her darkness?
No. It nearly killed her, but she tried.
Druth. Druth helped her.
If it wasn't for Druth, she'd be dead.
She can't beat her own darkness. She wanted to marry Dillian. She came to beat her own darkness. But she didn't work.
She thought her curse would affect him.
She thought her curse would spread to him.
She thought she'd bring the darkness to him too.
She nearly died.
She thought the curse made her tainted.
Druth helped her.
The Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of men was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds. Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from Muspel and made them into stars. And to protect the new world from the giants, they used Ymir's bleak, curving eyebrows.
Thank you.
The ravens.
They've gone.
They've gone.
No.
Half of them have gone.
They've gone.
Some still here.
But where?
Will Raven's helping?
No. He's not helping.
It's a trick.
Quiet. God's sake.
Out in the wilds. In the cold winter woods.
Where?
She no longer felt fit for this world. She almost gave in to the darkness. But she remembered Dillian's words. She remembered her promise. She resolved to fight on and kill that which had become a part of her.